I'm talking to Tunde Bakari. Tunde Bakari today. Okay, you are welcome once again. I'm talking to Pastor Tunde Bakari. Tunde Bakari of Letter and Assembly. I think his name of his church. I'm talking to him today according to what God said to me. God sent me to deliver to him. So I hear you, sir. I hear you because I have respect for you. I respect you. But all the respect I have for you vanished when you went to stand at the back of Buhari to contest for vice president of Nigeria. All the respect I have for you vanished. How can God I know, the God that created heaven and earth, say that you should forsake church and go and stand at the back of Buhari to contest for vice president? That was the time I know that no, something is wrong. But what marvels me is I know all that you did to Jonathan. You even at Ojota, how when Jonathan talk about subsidy, you are the leader. I can see you are on the front, on the front. You're on the front campaigning and just saying all kinds of things against Jonathan about the subsidy because you want to go and test power. You don't know the power, the one that you have. You that claim that you are hearing from the Almighty. Almighty, the one that controls the earthly authority. The one that controls the lesser, because Nigerian government is the lesser authority, the earthly authority is the lesser authority. You believe that you are under the greatest authority, under the highest authority. How can he tell you to go to the lesser one? It's what's called demotion, to demote you. How can he tell you to go and the contest and stand at the back of Buhari for presidency? Let us reason together. Let us not be in a hurry. Let us reason together. He demotes you. How will he demote you? He will demote you from the higher level to the lower level by telling you to go and stand at the back of Buhari to be his vice. Okay, you are one of the people that fought Jonathan. You said all kinds, even you are commanding plane to fall. Because when the rally was going on at Ojota over Jonathan decision, over the subsidy of a thing, you are even the one commanding. I see you, there's nothing you are not doing. Commanding as if to say, oh, the power, you are the one in charge of the power. If you belong to God, if you truly belong to God, because God will not answer you when you are doing the wrong, you are doing the wrong thing. Okay, you fought against Jonathan, you said all kinds of things against Jonathan. Now you are saying that Buhari have failed. I want to ask you, which God is speaking to you? Which God is talking to you? Can God say something and come out and say, oh, I made a mistake? It's not the God that I'm serving. God that I know will tell you something. Go up, go down. That thing is said, we stand. You said that God spoke to you to go to rescue Nigeria, to don't know whatever God said to you. And you believe that God have chosen Buhari to be the Nigerian president that will put things right. Now, the same God is here, Pharaoh, that you are saying again, you are the one saying now that you have seen that Buhari have failed. Buhari have failed his people. And I also hear you that you are saying that you want to go and contest that. I don't know what I'm saying. You said God is telling you to go and contest for presidency. Please, sir, I am interested to know who is speaking to you. I am interested to know Who is the God that you are serving that is talking to you? Because God spoke to me. God spoke to me about you. That's why I don't want to talk or to say anything until God instructed me to do so. You are seriously enemy to Jonathan government. But I can tell you 100% Jonathan government is better than Buhari. 1,000,000%. Jonathan government is far, far better. Better. Even in the midst of propaganda, in the midst of blackmailing him, he still show his class, he still show his good works. From day one that Buhari entered into power, all that people are experiencing is from one evil to another, from one killing to another, from one fair mind, from one level of fair mind to another. This is what people are experiencing. So, which God spoke to you, sir? Which God spoke to you that you should go and stand at the back of Buhari to fight for Jonathan, to fight for presidency? And I want to tell you something God sent me to tell you, sir. I want to read it for you to hear. What God said that I should tell you, the thing that you have been doing that is causing you problem. I'm reading the book of Ezekiel chapter 13 verse 3 for you, sir. Ezekiel chapter 13 verse 3. Thus says the Lord God, woe to the foolish prophet. Woe to the foolish prophet who follow their own spirit. Who follow their own spirit and have seen nothing. Thus says the Lord God, woe to the foolish prophets who follow their own spirit and have seen nothing. God said that you are following your own spirit, that you have never seen any vision. You see nothing. You have never seen any vision, that they have not spoken to you about what you are doing or what you are saying. God said that I should make it known to you that he have never spoken to you. He never commanded you that all that they are doing is out of your own spirit from day one. He have never spoken to you. Simple. I have to make it known to you so that you go and sit down. If you try to contest, I want to tell you, shame and disgrace. If you try to contest for presidency, shame and disgrace. I am telling you the truth. This is what you will see. Because God said, woe by himself. He gave it to me. Say, woe to the, thus says the Lord God, woe to the foolish prophets who follow their own spirit and have seen nothing. You have not seen anything. You have not seen any revelation. You have not seen any vision. You have never heard the voice of God. You haven't heard the voice of God. And you are coming to say, God said, you are speaking out of your own spirit. And this is what has been causing your problem. Even during the Obasanjo regime, the reason why they seize your passport is because you prophesy in the name of the Lord, but you are prophesying in the name of your own spirit that this and that will happen to Obasanjo after everything you said will fail. God can never send you or say something and that will not happen. How we God command to say something and you will speak it and that will not happen. This is what God said that I should tell you, that you should stop deceiving yourself. You should stop deceiving yourself that he have not sent you to speak those things that are speaking, to say those things that they are saying. So this is what I just want to tell you, what God said. All of you doesn't know the word of God, doesn't know whom Jesus is. All that you think is, I can speak grammar, I can take a scripture and I can preach, I can speak grammar, I can speak fluently. Doing the work of God, even if you are a stammerer or an illiterate, but once God's spirit is in you, no matter how you speak it or how you deliver it, it must manifest. This is the symbol of authority. God's spirit upon a man is the symbol of authority. People should stop deceiving the people. If God's spirit is not in you, you are none of his. You didn't belong to him. and to stop causing confusion to the people. This is what God sent me to tell you, sir, and I have done that.